Now, Christmas this year will apparently be no different from last year, according to majority of Filipinos. A new Pulse Asia survey shows 52% of respondents believe their Christmas celebration will be the same as in 2021. Of that number, only 42% said last year's Christmas was prosperous. Meanwhile, less than half of the respondents believe their celebration this year would be more prosperous than last year's. But Pulse Asia notes some 92% of Filipinos will face 2023 with hope.
Nakakagulat nga, considering ang daming tumaas na presyo, di ba? Siguro, mas nadalian sila this year compared to, kasi nung tinanong namin itong same question na to, noong 2020, yung pandemic, 8% lang ang nagsabing mas masagana compared sa 43%. Siguro, ang daming naghirap talaga sa pandemic noong 2020. Hindi namin yung kinundak last year.
But an economist paints a more pessimistic picture for next year.
Marami pong nagsasabi ngayon, nagbabadya ang pandaigdigang recession. Ang Amerika, ang Europe, lahat po sila naghahanda. Magiging challenging ang 2023. Well, global economy is slowing down. I think it will happen. It's not just a question na mangyayari ba o hindi. Ang palagay ko mangyayari ito. It's just a question na maaaring sa kalahati ng susunod na taon o bandang pahuli na ng taong susunod. Marami pong mawawala ng hanap buhay.
The Philippine government's chief economist optimistic the Marcos administration could exceed the government's growth target this year. Jackie Pascual reports.
The Philippine economy is expected to exceed government's growth target for the year despite current challenges. Socio-Economic Planning Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says the average gross domestic product or GDP growth rate for the first three quarters is already around 7.7% above government's target of 6.5 to 7.5% for the year.
Given the indication that we are seeing in the fourth quarter, it's likely going to exceed that even the upper limit of that range. We expect to see robust growth in the fourth quarter.
National Economic and Development Authority officials say the holiday season usually records high economic activity. One clear indication of this, they say, is the traffic congestion in major cities, despite the rising prices of goods and services.
Now we see our streets, right, the traffic jams in the streets and in the malls. Well, the fourth quarter, historically, that's a time when remittances come in. So remittances is helping boost consumption. Last year, we were unable to, go to the malls, right, to eat out a lot. So actually, when we go to the malls, we just jokingly say, it's the revenge of the Christmas trees and the Christmas lights.
But Balisacan says the government needs to do more as global economic challenges will remain next year. The target GDP growth for 2023 has been revised to 6 to 7% from a high of 8%.
We, of course, are aware of the global headwinds there, particularly the very likely recession for many advanced economies. The persistence of that problems with the supply chain, to seeing more manufacturing, more construction, more utilities, more even mining. We hope that would contribute strongly to medium-term growth. Agriculture, of course, is going to be also a driver.
Balisacan adds the Maharlika Investment Fund can help the economy by complementing other sources of funds for infrastructure projects, such as public-private partnership or PPP and official development assistance or ODA.
Maharlika Investment Fund is just another source of funds that will support our priorities. Infrastructure is a major challenge for us because, as you know, the fiscal space is given our response to the COVID is very limited, no? And we really need to generate a lot of investment resources.
President Marcos recently approved the Philippine Development Plan for 2023-2028, which will guide the country in the medium term. Among the plans is to generate more quality jobs and for GDP growth to hit 6.5 to 8% annually. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.